But you know what's really righteous? After the boyfriend leaves you or the girlfriend leaves you, you get really righteous, like more righteous than you've ever been in your life, and you start writing all this intense shit, and everything you write is profound, and everything you think is profound, and you know you'll never fall in love again now that your eyes have been, the blinders have been ripped away from your eyes, and now you see how things really are, you know? And, you know, you can, like, just fucking paint your walls black, turn the lights off, paint your fingernails black, put on, look like the guy in The Cure, dye your hair black, fucking grab a black piece of paper, black ink, and write manic poetry, and it'll all be good. Because you are the king or queen of pain. And you don't want to ever get over it, because it is so awesome. It was better than having the boyfriend or the girlfriend. I mean, this, you are, like, you know, righteous. And someone goes, why don't you cheer up? Why don't you go fuck yourself? You know, because it's way more fun just being like, ah, pain. No one knows the pain that I know. The weight of the world is right here. Try and knock it off. And, you know, and all those albums you have, all of a sudden, you know, the more schmaltzy and ridiculous the album, the more righteous it becomes. Fellas, this is a good one for you. This is what I do, and this is very embarrassing to admit it, but it's true. Whenever I get dumped, I nail the door shut so no one can come in. Get a towel, like an ordinary bath towel, put it around my neck, and take a paper clip and clip it so it's like a Superman cape. This is really embarrassing to admit this. I take my shoes off so I have my socks on so I can slide around the room. And I put on any record that features the vocalist Ronnie James Dio. And it's true. And you can just pretend you're Dio. And he's so righteous, but you need a cape, kind of, you know? And on every single album he does, there's minimum one, usually three, Evil Woman Look Out songs. And you can, like, what you want to do is you want to get, like, something you can hold, like a fake mic, like, you know, a celery stick or a pen or, you know, what, a magic mark or whatever. Make sure the door is locked. You've got your cape on, the socks, you slide across the room, and you got to get the hand signal right. If you want to point like Dio, it's a three-finger point. Like the Exodus, that way evil lurks. Evil lurks in twilight. Dances in the dark. I mean, he's so righteous, everything is, look out! Look out! Evil woman, just walk away! The guy... And you know the guy's been fucking hammered flat by chicks, man, because he's like this little evil gnome type guy. He's like this high. And so he has to write these, like, huge songs. Like when he was in that band Rainbow, he wrote that awesome song, Man on the Shiny Blue Mountain. I'm the man on the shiny blue mountain. We renamed it the Man on the Shiny Blue Milk Crate. Because he has to, like, jump up on the milk crate, like, all right. So, fellas, next time you go into that men's room, when you jump up on the platform, just don't, like, walk up on it. Like, look out. What's such a drag? Where do the girls get off? What can they play? A Marianne Faithful record? Oh, yeah. That ends your career, lady. Oh, Marianne, wait up. I got a salami I gotta hide still. Anyway. But that fat fuck Jim Morrison once said, he said, hold on to your depression. Hold on to your depression because it's some of the most righteous, intense moments you'll ever have. I mean, don't kill yourself, for God's sakes, but, you know, make sure you scribble some of that manic poetry, crank those Cure records, and keep those fingernails black. Black! Look out! This is serious shit, man.